Welcome to this lecture on ESXi virtual switch forwarding rules. Have you ever been confused between ESXi virtual switch supported and not supported data paths? Have you ever had question how traffic will be forwarded when two VMs running on same ESXi host of same virtual switch? Will traffic go through uplink or not? Have you ever had question what will happen when two VMs running on two different switch of same ESXi host? Will traffic leave the ESXi host switch or not? If yes, then please continue watching this tutorial. Hopefully, this tutorial should be able to clarify your data path queries regarding vSphere networking. Now, current diagram, what do you see here is a very basic layout of vSphere networking, and we are going to refer this layout for our virtual switch data path understanding. So let's get started. Now in this diagram, if you see, this is the box. What do you see? This is our entire ESXi host. This ESXi host, we have a two virtual switch created, vSwitch 0 and vSwitch 1. There are three VMs running on this ESXi host, whereas VM 1 and VM 2 running on vSwitch 0, whereas VM 3 running on vSwitch 1. Each of the VMs are having a single virtual network adapter. And if you look at the uplink side, vSwitch 0 is having a two uplinks, and vSwitch 1 is also configured with two uplinks. And if you see, first uplink of both of the virtual switches goes to a same physical switch, whereas the second uplink of both of the virtual switch goes to another physical switch. And it has been designed in a way to provide you a better redundancy or failover. So this is a basic vSphere networking layout. Now let's understand a first data path. For example, let's say we have a VM1 communicating with VM2. So the first data path, what we're going to discuss here is what will happen when VM1 generates a ping to VM2. So one probable path could be a packet coming from VM1 will be delivered to VNIC. From this VNIC, it might get delivered to your uplink 1. This uplink 1 can forward this packet to uplink 2. This uplink 2 will forward a packet to VNIC, and that's how it get delivered to VM2. Now, in this particular diagram, if you see what we have discussed, uplink 1 is trying to forward the packet to uplink 2. So always remember, uplink forwarding packet to another uplink. This particular data path or IO path is not supported in vSphere networking. There is no way a packet received by uplink 1 can be forwarded directly to uplink 2. That is a non-supported scenario in vSphere networking. Now, the supported scenario, in this particular case, when VM1 generates a ping to VM2, would be a packet coming from VM1. A packet coming from VM1 will be forwarded to vSwitch 0. vSwitch 0 internally will forward this packet to a VNIC of VM2, and that's how the packet would be delivered. So this is the supported IO path. When two VMs running on the same virtual switch, the traffic will never ever go over the uplink. The traffic will never ever go over the uplink, and the packet would be forwarded by virtual switch itself. And this is what we call intra-switch networking. So as you could see, VM1 talks to VM2. Traffic is forwarded by your virtual switch, and there is no traffic which goes over uplink. Remember, this point is very important to know. The traffic will not go over the uplink. Now let's look at another scenario where basically we will be discussing what will happen when what will happen when VM1 try to ping to VM3? And as you know, VM3 is running on different virtual switch of a same ESXi host. So one of the data path could be the traffic coming from VM1, it will go to its uplink, vSwitch to its uplink forwarded this path to this uplink might forwarded this packet to the virtual switch. This virtual switch can be received by this uplink and it will go via this path. This could be one of the path, or the second path could be a packet coming from VM can be received by virtual switch 0, and then it could be forwarded to virtual switch 1, and then it can be delivered to VM3. Now in this particular data path, if you see, the packet is not leaving ESXi host, or packet is not being forwarded to any of the uplinks. So as you could see, the packet is not being forwarded to uplinks. None of the uplink is receiving this packet, and the cascading of virtual switches is being utilized to forward the frame. Now again, this is again not a supported data path scenario. Always remember, in the vSphere networking, there is no concept of cascading of virtual switches. You cannot forward a frame coming from one vSwitch to another vSwitch directly bypassing your physical uplink. So always remember, the cascading virtual switch 1 or cascading of virtual switch 2 is not at all a supported scenario in vSphere networking. Now, how the data path would be in this particular scenario when VM1 is trying to ping VM3, the traffic would be, so traffic coming from VM to its VNIC, it will be forwarded to its respective uplink. From that uplink, it will go to the physical switch. Physical switch will forward this frame to this another uplink of vSwitch 1. From vSwitch 1, it will receive the frame and forward it to the VM3. So now, if you see in this particular scenario, the packet coming from a VM1 is going through ESXi host uplink, and from that uplink, it is received by another uplink of vSwitch 1, and then it's forwarded to VM3. So always remember, when two VMs, when there are two VMs running on two different virtual switch, vSwitch 1 and vSwitch 2, always remember, traffic has to go through their uplink VMNIC 0, and there could be, let's say, VMNIC 1. So traffic has to go through their uplink. That is the supported data path, or you could see this is a supported data path where basically two VMs running on two different virtual switch, the traffic has to go through their respective uplinks to deliver the frame. So this is a supported data path scenario. So just to conclude it here, if you could see, the vSwitch will forward the frames. vSwitch will always forward the frame between VM to VM. vSwitch will always forward the frame between VM to VM or VM to uplink, as you could see in this diagram. But vSwitch will never forward the frame from vSwitch to vSwitch. As you could see, from vSwitch to vSwitch, this is not at all a supported data path. And vSwitch will also not forward the frame from coming from uplink to uplink. Like as we discussed, vSwitch will never forward the frames from vSwitch 0 to vSwitch 1 or uplink 0 to uplink 1. These are the not supported data path in vSphere networking. So just to conclude it here once again, we only have a two supported data path. If two VMs running on same virtual switch, the traffic will not go over the uplink. Traffic will not go over the uplink. And when two VMs running on two different virtual switch, the traffic has to go through over the uplink to deliver the frames. So this concludes our tutorial on ESX virtual switch forwarding rules. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Thanks for watching it.